there is one person who has no issues with the ladies, and that's David Shuster. So we got something, we put a little something together here at Indisputable. We're gonna talk about it. Here it is.
Did he declassify it?
He said he declassified all of it.
By thinking about it.
I don't know about that.
He said that to Sean Hannity, that just by thinking about it, he declassified
Hannity every night, but
you missed one.
I watched it last night.
Does he have to sign something or tell people he's declassifying something?
Is this like left-wing news?
No, I'm just trying to push back because there are a lot of people who are confused.
Because at the end of the day, it was nothing but a trap and they fell for it. Ha!
Who's they?
The FBI, dear.
I believe that the FBI or someone else, you know, they packed those documents in there to frame Donald Trump.
How would the FBI get the nuclear secrets?
I have no idea.
Obama stored them in a warehouse where everybody could get to them.
For his library.
Yeah, for his library.
And the National Archives said that the National Archives actually ran that warehouse, not Barack Obama.
I don't know anything about that.
It was going for colonial militia. It started out as a pirate outfit.
It's the blood of an innocent child that are scared to death, and then it's extracted from their head, from their brains and their bodies, and it's used as a drug.
And who's doing that?
Joe Biden, Hunter, Clinton's.
If you would put in Epstein in certain key words, you will find the truth right there in front of you.
Can you point to me a single judge that has ruled that the election was stolen or that there was malfeasance that would have overturned the results of any state?
Look at the Supreme Court.
Well, the Supreme Court hasn't accepted any of these cases either.
How do you know that?
You'll find out 174.
174, what does that mean?
Gematria, God's language. It's good. It's good, but hey.
Gematria, that's that code thing, right? Yeah,
it is. Hey, you know what, well, Jackson, you know the song?
But why are we talking in code? Why are we talking code? Why not just tell me?
One, two, three.
Without a religion or without any kind of religion or basis of religion in the U.S., the country will fall apart.
If Congress passes a law or makes a declaration, we are a Christian nation, doesn't that go against the First Amendment?
Yeah, kind of.
Are you married?
I am, thank you, but I am flattered. Thank you. Thank you so much. You guys, enjoy the rally today. What have you been drinking? Have you been drinking anything today?
No. I hadn't drank in 3 years.
Good for you. Congratulations.
Yeah. Yeah. Until today.
Sir, all right. I love it. There's more, actually. Yeah. So, David, my man, I don't know how you do it, brother. Just give it to us in your own words. What was that experience like? And what was the most shocking out of all comments you received, the most shocking?
Well, clearly the woman who was asking me what my name was and that she thought I was cute. I haven't had that happen, I don't think ever that I've been in the field. But it goes to show that there's some people who show up at these MAGA rallies, not because they're into politics, because they're sort of like feeling like this is a Motley Crue concert and they're at the best concert ever and they're just kind of like gonna have a grand time and do whatever drugs or alcohol they're doing and flirt with whoever's there. There's another group that was there that surprised me a little bit, and that is, the number of people who will speak openly now about QAnon at these rallies is off the charts. And it used to be when we were doing these a year ago, some people just didn't want to talk about it or they're embarrassed. And I don't know whether it's a function that there are more people who believe in QAnon now or just a function of some people have peeled off these Trump rallies. They're getting smaller. And the people that are left are the ones who are the diehards, who are a higher representation of believing in these wacky conspiracy theories. And it's a conspiracy theory that requires them to suspend reality. And they're generally pretty polite and nice when you talk to them until you challenge them, and then they start to get defensive.
Let me ask you this. What's the common thread here? What have you found to be a basic common denominator with this variable of Trump support?
I think it's people who are generally not very well educated, who are confused by the world as it is, confused by 9/11, confused by the war in Iraq, confused by the pandemic, confused by an election where they thought, of course their guy should win. And so they're trying to make sense of all of this, and they don't have enough intellectual heft or education to be able to say, okay, some things happen a certain way because of cause and effect. They seem to think that there's a clear reason that will validate their own fears. And so that's why you have people drifting towards the conspiracy theories that Donald Trump was robbed, that the courts are all part of the deep state, that there's nobody who's actually looking out for Donald Trump except for the people who are trying to expose this pedophile cabal. And it makes sense to them, and that as a result, some of them they're very easy to talk to. They're very happy to talk about this because they're comfortable in their beliefs, even though the rest of us would say, but that flies in the face of reality. It doesn't match up with basic facts, and it's crazy.
You know, I don't believe anybody is above reproach. I think we all are human. I'm not immune to humanity. Everybody is human. What I've seen in scenarios like this is the inability to be critical of Donald Trump on any level.
Yes.
Even if you support left-leaning political figures, there's literally always some level of critique or criticism offered by people here at TYT and even those that subscribe to left-leaning political views. It seems to be absent as it relates to Trump supporters. They are unable, incapable of being critical of Donald Trump, even when the criticism is warranted based on facts that are evident. What do you say to that?
I think you're absolutely right. And look, we interviewed, I think, 30 people on camera. There were another perhaps 60 or 70 we asked if they would do an on-camera interview. They said no. But of the 30 people we interviewed on camera, I'd say one, maybe two, was willing to say, look, I like Donald Trump's policies. I have issues with how he handled things in office. I have issues with his lies or his personality. The rest, you're talking 27 or 28, they will not give an inch. They wow. believe that Donald Trump is a truth teller. We have got a video dropping today in which they claim, a lot of them, Donald Trump is the greatest president in US history. Better than Washington, better than Lincoln, better than Roosevelt. And the reasons for it are absurd, but that's their belief. And they're not willing to give an inch, particularly to somebody who's got a camera, who's with an organization that they may not be familiar with.
Fascinating. Continue to do the great work that you do. Continue to bring us these amazing stories and insight. For those who would like to follow your work, check out your work, how can they do so?
They can go to RebelHQ on YouTube or Facebook, or they can follow me on Twitter at David Shuster. Our videos are up there. And Dr. Richey, I guarantee the next time somebody comes up to me and asks me, hey, cutie, what's your name? I'm going to say, Dr. Rashad Richey.
Don't do that.
Email, and we'll see what happens.
Now, damn it. Now, we're going to fall out, Dave, if you do something like that. All right.